Another question I've asked coaches is about programs, and you actually, as I was driving over, I was thinking I might ask you, how far back can you see anybody other, any other coaches' fingerprints here still, and anything that they've done, and maybe if you inherit anything, and what's your philosophy of the program is?
I think anywhere you go, unless you open a school, there's going to be fingerprints. The school that I was at prior, you know, you leave fingerprints. Some probably viewed as good, some maybe viewed bad or poorly, but, you know, you're always going to leave a thumbprint, if you will. Mm-hmm. And those things have been left here, and some good, obviously, and you want to build off those things. You know, you don't want to rewrite something that doesn't need to be rewritten, and you want to find things that guys have done in the past that have built into pride in the program. Maybe the guys are doing things well, and you don't want to completely have a overhaul because just based off of my ego or any coach's ego, you know, like, well, we got to change it because so-and-so was here, and I don't want it to look like we're just doing what he was doing. Because we all, I mean, ultimately as coaches, we're going to, if we all get in a room, we're all going to bounce ideas off of one another and take things, and, you know, that's why people are running the spread, right? Because they saw an idea or they heard an idea from somebody else, and we're all kind of doing it now. We modify it. We meet with other coaches, and because we want our programs to be the best, and so we use things from the past to make us better. We use things from the past to, you know, the pride that somebody may have built into this program 10, 15 years ago, and we want to continue to try to play into that. And you know, there's been some good coaches here. They've done some good things. And so what we've tried to do is something that I think is really important to us is trying to build pride within our team, you know, and depending on where you're at, that may take 1 year. In other places, it may take 5 years. And it just depends on who you have. And our guys are, what's great about this is our guys are really bought in to what we're doing. They bought into the weight room. They bought into the type of culture that we're trying to create here. We want our guys to be tough, hardworking, and at the same time, they need to understand how to treat one another. They need to understand that the guy that's working out next to them, they've got to find a way to positively motivate him to be the best he can be. And so that's kind of where we're at, and you know, kind of the mindset of iron sharpens iron, right? So, you know, if you and I are both running backs, then we need to compete with one another to make each other better. You know, if I beat you out, it's only because you made me better, you know, and if you beat me out, it's because you made me better, or I made you better, you know. Right. So we want our guys to feed off one another and make themselves the best they can possibly be. And that's a culture that you take into, you know, every year. And that's something that I feel like we've finally gotten to the point where our guys are really wanting to make one another better. Something else that I think is extremely important is continuity in your staff. I'm fortunate to have a pretty good staff, a group of guys that have been together now for 3 years. We've had essentially the same group of guys, and you know, we changed our offense a little after my first year. We changed our offense a lot after my first year, but we changed it, and you know, that group of offensive guys now, this will be their second year. My offensive coordinator has had a whole off season to be with our team, and so he's had a spring, and now have a whole summer to be with the offensive guys. And defensively, we're going into our third year, essentially running the same thing. Obviously, you're always tweaking, you're always modifying things, but that kind of continuity, I think, makes your team better. You know, and you look at teams around the area that have had coaches, some of the teams we talked about, or programs we talked about earlier, they've had guys in the same places for a long time, and they've got guys on their staff that played there and that love not only, you know, love football, but they love that program because right. They've been invested in it, and I think that's where we're at as well with our coaches. They really care about Providence football. They care about the area. They care about the kids, and I think you mix players that have a passion for not only their teammates but their program, and you take coaches that have the same passion. Now you're mixing that together, and you can create something great. And I think that's kind of where we're going. And I'm extremely optimistic about where our program's heading.
That's awesome.